You can ride it like a motorbike, but on water. The proper term for it is personal watercraft, or PWC, but you probably call it a jet ski. They're fast, agile, and super fun. But how do they work? The main body is typically constructed from fiberglass, while some high-performance models, well, they feature carbon fiber to reduce weight. So the shape of the hull is called a modified V planing hull. Modified V means the hull has a pointed, V-shaped bow that gradually flattens as it moves toward the stern. A planing hull is designed to help the jet ski glide across the water surface as speed increases. So if you look at the bottom of the hull, you'll see a large opening leading to a tunnel that extends toward the back. This tunnel's called the suction duct. It's part of the propulsion system, and it's the most unusual feature of a jet ski. So the impeller goes inside the suction duct. It looks like a turbine, but in reverse, because a turbine rotates when something flows over it, like wind, whereas an impeller creates a flow by rotating. The impeller is usually driven by a four-stroke gasoline engine via a shaft. When it spins, it creates suction, drawing in water from below and forcefully ejecting it through a nozzle at the back. This high-speed water jet propels the jet ski forward. So, in a way, this jet of water is what makes a jet ski, a jet ski. And this technology is called water jet propulsion. Now, since the rotating part is tucked inside the suction duct, jet skis don't have exposed propellers at the back, like, well, traditional boats. This propulsion system is powerful, giving jet skis quick acceleration and high top speeds, but it comes at the cost of fuel efficiency. In fact, jet skis are notorious for how quickly they can run out of fuel. Riding a jet ski is easier than it looks, even simpler than riding a scooter. You control your speed with the throttle grip. More throttle makes the engine spin the impeller faster, expelling more water from the back and increasing speed. To steer, you simply turn the handlebar in the direction you want to go. Unlike traditional boats, jet skis don't have a rudder. Instead, the water jet nozzle moves when you turn the handlebar, redirecting the jet. This creates a turning force that makes the jet ski change course. This design is called an integrated steering system because propulsion and steering are combined into, well, a single unit. It allows for tighter turns, a smaller turning radius, and, well, better maneuverability on the water. On some models, you'll find a trim adjustment button on the left handle. The trim adjustment changes the vertical direction of the jet nozzle. Tilting the nozzle upward pushes the bow higher, which allows you to go faster. Tilting it downward forces the bow down, improving stability and, well, you know, turning capabilities. And what about stopping? When you pull the brakes, a component called the reversing gate covers the nozzle, redirecting the water jet forward and causing a rapid slowdown. Or if this feature isn't available, you can just, well, stop accelerating and turn the jet ski, and the resistance of the hull will do the job.